Hey, it's me, it's Shotzi. It's week 29 of Socially Isolating, and I know you, like me, are very excited, because we're coming up on one of the most exciting, creepy holidays of the year. That's right, I'm talking about Canadian Thanksgiving. Canadian Thanksgiving is almost here. So if you are Canadian right now, I hope you are ready to give thanks. We here in America won't be able to give thanks until sometime in November. So until then, let me talk to you about some fun stuff I've been learning about. Like, well, you know, I've told you that I very much relate to that Jack Handy deep thoughts where he said, in a past life, I must have been a great and mighty king because I like for people to do what I say. Well, you know that is true. And I got something great. Do you know about Dover Books? Dover Books, they do a lot of inexpensive republications of historic books, and they also used to do clip art books back in the day when you actually would clip art. And they also do fancy paper dolls. And I recently got, King Henry VIII. What greater joy, what greater fun play could a kid have but to pretend to be the king who broke with the Catholic Church so that he could marry again and then execute his wife. This is just great. And Tom Tierney draws these. They also had a book called Chinatown with costumes, but you know, they didn't have any of Faye Dunaway's costumes, so I thought, who's gonna buy that? Anyhow, another book I've been enjoying, I thought it was, at first it was boring, but now I like it. It's called The Strange History of Buckingham Palace by Patricia Wright, and it talks about why there was a big piece of property near downtown London, near the city of London, that could be the site for a big country house. Originally, the Duke of Buckingham built a big house there. But the property was originally kind of gross and swampy for much of the Middle Ages. And there was a little village there called Ebury or Eye. And when King Henry V died and left his very young baby son, Henry VI, to be king, there was a witch that lived in the village of Eye named Marjorie Gardemaine, the Witch of Eye. And the king, the late king's younger brother, Humphrey of Gloucester, who was second in line to the throne after the baby, well, his wife, Eleanor, was accused of consulting with the Witch of Eye so that the baby king would die and her husband would be king. Well, there must have been a mole in their group who either suggested the witch or else just reported it, but the whole thing got busted and a lot of people got hanged, the witch got burned, the countess, the Duchess of Gloucester, interestingly, was forced to walk penitent through the city of London in just a simple shift and bare feet. So I think George R. R. Martin might have learned about that, to transform that into Circe's walk through King's Landing in naked. She was naked. Lena Headley. Well, but Eleanor of Gloucester didn't have to be naked. But anyhow, there's stuff on TV too, and I've been enjoying Lovecraft Country, bump, 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 on HBO, starring Jonathan Majors as Atticus Freeman, and Journey Smollett, and Michael K. Williams, who we all know from The Wire. He is Omar. It's based on the novel Lovecraft Country by Matt Ruff, and it is a real exciting twist on some horror story tropes and sort of the mythology of Lovecraft's world. And besides that, there is a new Netflix series called The Haunting of Bly Manor, which is inspired by The Turn of the Screw. And I was going to hold that up, but I don't know where the heck it is. It's somewhere. It didn't go anywhere. I didn't lend it. But nevertheless, it disappeared. Eerie. But anyhow, I'm going to check out The Haunting of Bly Manor on Netflix. And I can't wait for a new episode of Lovecraft Country. And I hope you all have a wonderful Canadian Thanksgiving. Talk to you later. Ugh.